Superman and not slide on the kryptonite ground surfaces of turn two or turn four to win on Stock Car Racing's All-Star Night. Hi everybody, once again, Mike Joy, Larry McReynolds, and Darrell Walter, both winners of Stock Car Racing's All-Star event, and the fever pitch just kind of builds. You know, every cup race is an all-star race, but tonight this is special.
You got to be Superman. You got to be Batman, and you got to be the Lone Ranger, because you're going to have to dodge a lot of bullets if you're going to win this baby.
Yes, you will. And Darrell, you talked about how gut-wrenching it is for that driver, for those teams, for that crew chief, because in this first segment, either on lap 14 or 15, a mandatory green flag stop. You know a mistake right there can take you right out of this race. Then a decision with 20 laps to go before that third segment, just like in the open a while ago. Do we pit? Do we stay out? Two tires, four tires? That could be difference in winning and losing this race.
Whatever, it's going to be fun and it's going to be memorable. I think that one we talked about that you won was the first one here under the lights.
And there was a full moon, I might remind you.
And after it was all over, driver standing around in the garage, and Richard Petty goes, what do these people all still sitting here think? We're going to go out and do this again? Well, we have every year since.
There it is.
It's time. Time to go trackside for the star and producer of Fox's show, Stacked, to give the command.
Now let's hear it for tonight's Grand Marshal. She's the star of the new Fox sitcom, Stacked. Please welcome Pamela Anderson as she delivers those most famous words in motorsports.
Gentlemen, start your engines! Woo!
Give that an E for enthusiasm, and that's the kind of fun we're going to see all night long here. Let's go down to Dick Bergeron.
I tell you, Mike, the excitement, the enthusiasm down here on pit road is real. These guys, Ryan Newman's guys, dove into the crowd after they were introduced. We saw some of the crews coming out with water cannons, others with cameras to take pictures. The crowd up in the grandstand, they're rocking. The drivers are excited. They're ready to go. We are too. Steve Burns.
Thanks, Dick Berger. Jimmy Johnson told me his first win in a stock car was in Memphis, Tennessee, in a series known as ASA. It didn't even pay $10,000 to win, but that didn't matter. Jimmy won this event in 2003, taking home $1 million, and he's got a chance to do it again here tonight. Matt Yoakum.
We've heard all night, Steve Burns, about what this race means to the crew members, what this race means to the fans, and what this race especially means, this All-Star Trophy event, what it means to the drivers. Now, Jeff Gordon, you heard him earlier say, it's a combo platter, a lot of money, a lot of pride on the line, but it could be a special night for Super G. He's tied with the late Dale Earnhardt. Three apiece All-Star Challenge victories. A win tonight, he will become the all-time All-Star winner, and that's worth a lot more than $1 million.
Jeff Gordon with three, the late Dale Earnhardt with three victories in the All-Star event. There they are, 22 cars are at the ready. As we get out to Chris Myers for this, he's a race break.
Thanks, Mike, with Jeff Hammond of the Hollywood Hotel after being out near the stage. Usually the All-Star break and different sports guys relax, ease up. There's a lot of tension down there, not only with the crews, but the drivers as well.
Well, most All-Star deals, you're trying to have fun, but this is right here for $1 million. We keep talking about it, 135 miles, $7,400 per mile. I mean, how impressive can that be?
What are the buzzwords you're hearing from guys around the track?
Right now, factors. Factors such as the levigating on the track.
Levigating.
Yes, levigating.
A magician does that?
That's what I'd like to do to you, make you disappear.
That's agitating.
But the other thing, the tires and the way they grip the racetrack, the multi-grooves around there, it's going to challenge everybody. We saw in the first set race up there how these guys can run top to bottom, almost go three wide. So it's going to be real interesting to see how these factors play in tonight.
In the Nextel Open, a reminiscence, you go back to the baseball all-star game with Pete Rose taking out Ray Fosse, what it's supposed to be for fun. Brian Vickers doing that to Bliss to be in this race. And we're getting ready for the Nextel All-Star Challenge from Lowe's Motor Speedway. This has been a Visa Race Break. America's best driver on display here on FX.
The Nextel All-Star Challenge is brought to you by Budweiser, the official beer of NASCAR, and proud sponsors of Dale Earnhardt Jr. and the number 8 car. Johnsonville trivia. You already know this, so we'll tell you the answer right away. Only two drivers have won the All-Star Challenge from the pole, Dale Earnhardt and Davey Allison, who did it twice. And that first time under the lights was that was my most exciting memory in the whole history of All-Star races. It was right here at Lowe's Motor Speedway. And Davey Allison had to fight off first Alan Kowicki and then Dale Earnhardt and then battle get Kyle Petty, and here they come.
But it started right here, Mike, right here when Kyle Petty got into Dale Earnhardt, shoved him up the racetrack, wrecked him. Now Kyle says, okay, I got it made. I'm on my way to victory lane. But he forgot about, he lost a little momentum, opened the door for Davey. Davey gets to run on the inside, says, Kyle says, dadgone it, I missed one.
Allison hit the wall hard, went to the care center instead of victory lane. And when he woke up, he asked Robert Yates and Larry, did we win?
I was in the ambulance with him, and even though he was hurt, that's all he wanted to know, did I win? And I said, yes, you did. Remember, then it only paid a third of what it pays now.
Remember, then we had special cars, special engines, special everything. Now you just have disposable cars.
Here is the Nextel starting grid for tonight's All-Star Challenge. The first three drivers, Newman, Martin, and Rusty Wallace, are all past winners of the All-Star race. Sadler in a Ford, Casey Kane, who just barely made it in, squeaked in with his win last Saturday night at Richmond. Jimmy Johnson, who's banked the million here. Carl Edwards, rookie in this race. And Kurt Busch, who's been second. Joe Nemechek, Matt Kenseth, who banked the million last year. Greg Biffle, right now arguably the hottest driver on the tour. And patient, steady Bobby Labonte and his older brother Terry, who's been in all but one of these All-Star events. Jeff Gordon's won three of them. Jeremy Mayfield and Michael Waltrip, who's also a past winner. Tony Stewart, coming from deep in the field with Kevin Harvick, Dale Jarrett, and Dale Earnhardt Jr. And then from the open, Vickers and Truex.
You've got to be aggressive, but you also got to remember, don't wreck this thing until I get to the end where the $1 million is. Don't take yourself out in one of these early segments.
Now, the rules are just like any cup race, except for these. 30 or 90 laps total, mandatory green flag pit stop. At a certain point in the first segment, there's a three-lap window when you have to pit. There'll be an inversion. It might be six, it might be 12 drivers or somewhere in the middle. No elimination, that's been done away with. And all restarts, like in the open, double file. First place next to second place, third place next to fourth place, and so on.
And that's gonna play a key role on these restarts, with the outside of turns 1 to 2 being the place to be.
You know what? Here's the weather. Heck with it. All I know is it's just hot out there, and we're going racing. It doesn't matter how hot or cold it is.
You've turned off the weather channel.